Hey, welcome back to my playthrough of SnowRunner. This is Rob with Best Practice Gaming. And in my last playthrough, I was recovering some trucks, but I ran into a downed bridge and, of course, some fallen rocks, because that's what you always run into in SnowRunner. If it's not that, it's a bridge that needs to be rebuilt with some wood. So I've got the International here. This is my only highway truck. I'm going to use this to try to restore that bridge. So let's get over and get a piece of metal. To chime in here, I've never actually used this truck for a mission. The first thing I do when I get this truck is I just sell it off, because it is like one of the weakest trucks in the game. So this will be interesting. Thank you. Oof. Well, that was the International 470A to the rescue there. SnowRunner's smallest truck available. And me driving the International that way and pulling the freight around the way I was pulling it, it's like very old school first gen SnowRunner driving. These days it's all about modded trucks or having the biggest trucks that can haul the freight through any type of terrain. I might be exaggerating that a little bit, but the small 470A, that's kind of a little bit harder to drive because it's the smallest truck in the game. And other than getting it over the hills, it actually performed really well. I managed to get it over the off-road terrain and the hills all right. I just think it'll do a lot better with a lot of upgrades. I'm not sure what that truck was doing stuck in a swamp, but that's where we found it. So it's getting pretty late tonight, and then I will catch up with you guys with more gameplay sometime later on this week. Take it easy. And be sure, if you like Best Practice Gaming, to like and subscribe.